So let's start with the evolution of an expert. So I'm going to start from level one until level five. And as I'm explaining this to you, I want you to observe and think about yourself. Think about how you have chosen your niche, how you have positioned yourself, whether it's in alignment with what we are doing over here. If it's not in alignment, you'll be able to make those corrections as I shared this. Okay. So let's look at the evolution of an expert. Go back in the day. We had, when there were no schools, we had gurukuls, okay? Back in the day, in the village day. So you would have the expert, you would have the master, and you would have the student who would actually go and live with the master. And even look at the great epics like Mahabharata and all that, they would actually go live there. And there was no classification of people, as far as their, castes or anything is concerned. Everybody would learn under a particular age, and based on their capabilities, their skill sets, and even based on their inclinations, they would move into the four different divisions of society. They would either be in an administrative role, or they would move into an intellectual role, or they would move into a business role, or they would move into a more support role. So that's why you have this Brahmana, Vaishya, Shudra, and stuff like that. Okay. So back in the day, the whole segmentation of society was based on, not based on birth, but based on inclinations and based on what they should call as swabhava, or the innate nature of an individual, what is coming naturally to a person and how they could contribute back to the community and back to the society. Okay. So that was the initial form. Students would go learn and they would come back. Then later on, we had this whole evolution of the education industry, and then it came, when the Britishers came in, they introduced the education system that we know what it is today. And because it was the industrial era, they wanted people who could really follow a particular regimen, a particular system, and that's why everything was modeled around the factory model. So like ringing bells, kids batched in age groups, every one size fits all kind of a model, and people progress through the education system, and they would be bringing out robots on the other side who would do work, and they would do exactly this precision work. There's nothing good or bad about it, but that was the need of the hour in the last 100 years. Okay, now the world is changing today. How many of you realize that we are living in a completely different world compared to when we were in school days? Okay, I can talk about myself. 90s studying in school was completely different. Okay, I was more outdoor. Everything was, there was no technology, and it was a very different world. And if I compare this to what my parents lived in, the kind of world that they lived in, that was a drastically different world. So the way the world is evolving right now is just insane. In fact, some of you may not even realize it, but just in the last 15 years, the way that technology has taken over the world, even the last 50 years did not experience that kind of a growth. Okay, that kind of, I wouldn't say growth, but that kind of an evolution in the landscape of how we live. How many of you agree with me on that? Yeah. Did any of you think that your auto driver or your vegetable vendors would be, doing stuff on their smartphones? No way. Okay. Never possible. So right now we are on a more level playing field, where the opportunity that is there for a person who's on the lowest strata of society, and even Mukesh Ambani, the access of information is on a level playing field. The access of technology is on a level playing field. So what is going to stop us from achieving success is it's our own mindset. That's it. Okay. There's nothing else. So we have kind of equalized in everything, right? Even in gender, there's equalization right now in the different societies. So there's actually no reason for you to give any excuse for not being successful in today's age, because the conditions are so perfect right now in all ways. Access to knowledge, because even in the olden days, people who would read more books, people who would have access to knowledge, they would have the power. But now even a guy on the street has access to Google, right? So the way that we look at an expert compared to what it used to be has also changed. Previously, I would say, people 15 years back, 20 years back, the more degrees that they would have, we would call them as an expert. But today it is very different. Those who are skilled and those who are able to learn fast and who are able to apply knowledge quickly, they're the ones who are actually surviving the game. Okay. Guys, look at the YouTubers in the US. The average age of a millionaire YouTuber is some 13 years old or something like that. Like, these guys are hands-on, born into technology, doing stuff. And the people who have the tails of degrees and all the doctorates and stuff like that, unless they're doing some heavy duty research, you know, to really contribute to some big breakthrough for the future. I don't think there's, so much of water in the ocean, but you just cannot drink that. It's like overqualified people who cannot apply that knowledge. How many of you are with me in this? Yeah, just I'm with you in the comment box. See, there are four categories of people that I can observe based on this. You have some people who are like the ocean. Okay, they have so much, are overqualified, you know, having tails of degrees, but you cannot even access. I mean, you cannot apply that knowledge anywhere. So that's like the ocean. Then you have the second category. I'm forgetting. I think there are three categories. The second category of person who's like the marshy, what exactly, Nina? You mentioned the marshy, where it's like a marshy plain, but there is like water, but it's very shallow and it is very muddy. So these are people who are not masters of their craft. Like they are like jack of all trades. They know little of everything, but they can't really use that anywhere. Okay. They can use it to have conversations, but they cannot practically apply that knowledge anywhere. Then you have a third category, which is the well, the people who really dig deep and they dig a well in such a way that they can keep pulling out and drinking water for the rest of their life. So what we are creating here is what I'm going to walk through these different five levels is how you can become a person, a knowledge giver or an expert where you can create a well for yourself. You're not an ocean and you're not a marshy land. Okay. You're not a marshy plain or whatever, but there's a lot of water which you cannot even drink there. Okay. So keeping that in mind, you need to understand that the expert in today's age can be segmented into five levels, bringing in the element of technology also. Okay. So let's look at the first level. The first level is DFY. So if you're an expert and if you say, I will do this for you as an expert, that is the most lower end of the spectrum. So let's say you are a web developer, you're a graphic designer, you're providing some kind of a service. Okay, whatever. You can help heal people or you're going to do something. So if you're going to do some activity for somebody else, you're trading your time for a service. That is the bottom most end of the five levels. It is important. See, if I had not built websites on my own, if I had not set up such systems of my own, if I had not done all this stuff, you know, including the video editing and all the stuff on my own, I wouldn't have known what it takes. Okay. So it's important for all of you to do it yourself. That's why I ask everyone in our community to build your own websites, to build your own systems, to get independent, because once you're hands-on, then you don't need to depend on anyone. However difficult it may seem initially, but once you get through that hurdle, once you get through that technology challenge, which is only in your mind, okay? Once you just push through that, then when you look back, you'll feel much, much more confident what you're doing. Okay, so the first thing is, the first level is the DFY guys. So once you've done enough of this, and once you've, say, built a few websites, you've built your own systems, once you have some confidence, then the second level of an expert is somebody who's a do-it-with-you format. Okay, now some of you may be in this second category right now. How many of you are in this category where you do some work for your clients, but you do some part of it and you make them do some part of it? Just type me in the comment box if you happen to be in this category. Yeah. Yes. Some of you are in this. So even like for example, let's come back to the example of website. So if you're developing websites, initially you would say, I will do everything. I will write the copy. I will put the images. I'll do this. But then once you get good at it, you can start to call the shots. Say, you know what? I'll put up the system. You give me the content. You give me the images. You give me all these things in the format that I'm going to ask you. And once they give it to you, then you actually share the load. Okay. So this is the second level of an expert in today's day and age. The next level, the better level compared to this is one-to-one coaching. That means, you know, I will tell you what to do and you do it. I coach, you do. So how many of you are in level three? Just type L3. If you're a coach, that means you're trading your time for money, but then you're not doing any work. You're making them do the work. You're giving them the guidance on what they have to do. Okay. Excellent. So if you're in this level, and you know what, I would highly recommend all of you spend time in this level number three, because only then you will know what your market really wants. You know, I've done over 350 plus one-to-ones for me to understand exactly what you need. Now I'm not doing one-to-ones, not as many. You know, I'm only having my Freedom Breakthrough session, and I'm not doing like as many as how they used to. Everything is automated right now. Okay. And I'll tell you why I've done that. Because if I was still doing one-to-ones, I wouldn't be able to scale. Okay. So there is a level to which you should do your one-to-ones. And after that, once you understand your market really well, you can systemize that. And that's coming to level number four. So level number four is group coaching. So right now, what I'm doing is group coaching, in the sense we have all of us in our community together, and I'm coaching all of you on a particular concept or subject, but I'm also having a level five, which I'll talk to you about. Okay. So group coaching is better than one-to-one coaching, because in one shot, you're going to get giving value to everyone. Okay. See, after doing over 300 plus 50 one-to-ones, I understand that pretty much everyone has the same needs. Okay. The same kind of problems, identifying the niche, getting clarity on their game plan, you know, breaking through their mindset, breaking through their productivity issue. I mean, if you have, you know, I just made a list of all the things that really stops people from achieving success. And I know my 5-6 points. Okay. So I've constructed all my trainings and coachings based on the feedback that I'm getting from all of you. So based on the feedback, I'm now creating group coaching format. So whenever we meet on Thursdays, I pick up topics based on the feeler I'm getting from all of you, so that I can help and address your needs. Okay. So level four in group coaching. How many of you are in group coaching? Just type L4 in the comment box. That means you're not doing any one-to-one, but you're only working in groups. Now that's much better, because it's much more efficient. You can create a much higher impact, and you can get people faster results as a group, you know, taking feedback from the group. Fantastic. Okay. Now comes the ultimate. Okay, the ultimate. The ultimate is what Vic opened my mind to. Okay. And this is the world we're talking about. We're looking at the digital ecosystem model. Okay. Now, this is exactly what I'm doing right now. If you notice, when I launched my course last year, I had only like Freedom Business Model, Freedom Setup Challenge, and 90 Days to Freedom. So it's all of Vic's videos. I have only 3 courses. Now I have around 15 courses. What I've been doing is, as the community was growing, I started to record all these calls, and I started to package them into different products based on the feedback that I'm getting from all of you. And I put them into my ecosystem, which is my internet lifestyle hub. So I don't have to be in it. In the sense, if anybody's emailing me with any kind of question, I'm only pointing them to the right resources, which has already been explained. So I'm duplicating myself, and I'm creating an ecosystem where I'm cross-selling multiple things. If you observe what I'm doing inside my ecosystem, yes, all of you came to my Freedom Business Model, but once you get into my Freedom Setup Challenge, I have at least 10 different income streams by me recommending to you the right tools. So I have all the income streams by me recommending to you the 4%. Anything which is in alignment to you achieving your goal, I'm including that and putting that into this community here. Okay. So talking about ecosystems, just to give you a better idea, how many of you saw the keynote yesterday, Apple keynote? Of course, I didn't see the keynote. I saw the news later on, the iPhone 11 launch. Okay. So that's the biggest talk of the town right now, right? So everybody wants to go for the new iPhone, and they want to go for the new MacBook and stuff like that. Not MacBook, no, I think the iPad. So look at Apple. Apple is an ecosystem. Okay. And the reason they're one of the most cash rich companies in the world is because they have created an ecosystem model. And the evolution of an expert, if you see, if you are able to think in terms of ecosystems, you will build a well for yourself for the rest of your life, where you can keep pulling water out. Okay, you'll never go dry. And it is your own well. It is not somebody else's well. It is your own well. So here, when you buy an iPhone, for example, you tell me in the comment box, what do you do next? What do you have to buy after you buy the iPhone? Yeah, you got to get the apps, right? You got to get their app store. So in the app store, there are many free apps. They'll have like the free freemium, you'll buy, and then you'll start to download all these different apps. And then once you pick up the app store, then you think, okay, why not I get the watch? Okay, these apps, the watch will go well with this. Then why not I get the MacBook Pro so I can get into the same email? Then why not I get the iMac? I'm a classic example of somebody who's just hooked into the Apple ecosystem, and I cannot get out of it. Okay, so this is what I mean by creating an ecosystem which can feed itself. Okay. Yeah. Your battery case, you have the case, you have like this whole auxiliary or the accessory industry is a multi-billion dollar industry. Just the Apple accessory industry itself is a multi-billion dollar industry. For how many of you, the bulb is just gone on right now. Just type bulb on in the comment box. You'll never understand the depth of what I'm telling you guys until you realize ecosystem. I'm not just here to teach you how to create a course and launch a course, e-learning business. That's just my hook to get you in, okay, into my freedom business model. But what I eventually want you to become is a master of ecosystems. And Vic, I learned this from him because he's got an ecosystem of, I think currently over 300,000 members in his ecosystem. 300,000 members. I've got 6,000 members. He's got 300,000 members. So now you can calculate and see, okay? When I say the guy is making $1 million per month, you know, and he's not even selling low ticket. No, he's selling at $1,000 level, internet traffic mostly $1,000. Do you think out of 3 lakh people, a few people will buy, like if 1,000 people buy a $1,000 product, he's done his million. That is what I'm talking about. Okay, but to reach and build it to that level, you will have to go through your learning curve. You need to go through these different phases. Okay, so coming back to this, let's come back over here. Yeah. Let me come to, yeah. Or if you're seeing the Apple ecosystem, yeah. So now Vic, I think I shared this with all the guys in the game championship. So Vic, he's my mentor. He's the father of 6 kids, okay? 4 boys, 2 girls. And the reason I picked Vic as my mentor is because I could resonate with his value system. Okay, there are different ways to build a business, but I was really impressed by his way of building a business, which is 4 employees, $1 million a month, a lot of free time. Of course, now he's really working towards the 4-person 4.0 launch, and he's really, focused on that. But I asked him, how many people do you have on your team, and what do they do? He says, I have a developer who's outsourced. I mean, he's exclusive only for the 4-person who does all the customization work. He's got a graphic designer. He's got 1 customer support. Okay, like a couple of people under that team, but he got 1 person handling it. And what else? He has 1 more person. I think his finance. Okay, and of course he's got outsourced tax and he's got tax and legal. That's also another company which is all outsourced. So this guy, 33 years old, father of 6 kids, doing $1 million per month. Okay, and the interesting thing is this guy is not aggressive on social media. Yeah, he's got a pretty good YouTube channel. If you've seen on the 4-person, he's never sold from the stage. He's never written a book. He's not like a super influencer like Gary Vee and this and that. He's really not like flashy out of the pan, you know, just 4 employees, and he's achieving these kind of results. That's what impressed me. Okay. How many of you did not know this? Just type DNK in the comment box. DNK is did not know. For me, how to make money or how we make money is more important than making that money. There are some people who love to work hard and grind it and do it. But there are some others like Vic who's mastered the efficiency part of the game. And he has filled in the efficiency component. By being efficient, he's filled up other areas of life which are important, which is family, spirituality, and what else? Yeah, and impact. These are some of the other things which I really could resonate with, okay? And one more thing I observed in Vic's, his secret is because he's a master in digital ecosystems. He's hands-on in every single part. He's tried every single traffic source. He's integrated every single system. And now he's mastered the whole aspect of traffic, list building, automated selling, multiple income layers, and digital tribe building. How many of you now get the bigger picture right now, what I'm talking about? The evolution of an expert. Just type get it in the comment box. Type get it. Because if you are an expert, you have to start thinking and building your business in terms of an ecosystem model, not in any of these levels. These levels, you need to do it initially, but you need to evolve into the ecosystem model. Now, I would recommend, even if you're selling your tripwire or your first level product, initially, when I sold my courses, Freedom Business Model did not have any one-to-one coaching. If somebody would buy my level 2 product, which is my Freedom Startup Challenge, I would give them my one-to-one for free, which is not there right now. I should do that. So you can, in case you're starting off and you want just better traction, right? You can even include your one-to-one along with your level 1 product. So you sell your course in a webinar, and say, since I have limited time slots, I'm willing to give 30 minutes of my time. You know what? It will be so useful. Do it only for the first 30, 40, 50 people. You'll get so much of feedback from your market. Then you can stop that and move into level two. Okay. So you'll work with a different set of people and you can guide them on implementation. And once you understand all their pain points, once you reach over 300 to 400 customers, then you can stop that and you can take all those insights and create another product and put that back into your ecosystem. Okay. Then you can get more feed. So for me to come to this stage, it has taken me 1 year of getting feedback from all of you. Please note that this game, it's not a cookie cutter model. I've given you these steps over here, but only when you implement your courses, only when you implement this, you will get feedback from your market and you'll know what your market needs. So if I'm doing something, it doesn't mean that you'll have to do the same thing. You have to apply the feedback that you're getting from your own customers. Does this make sense? Yeah. Yes, type yes in the comment box if this makes sense. Because this is a fundamental principle which I would like all of you to understand, that even if some of you are my franchisees, right? You've taken my franchise license and stuff. The way that you nurture your community will be very different from the way that I nurture this community, because you are different. I am different. All of us are different here. We are all unique individuals. You have your own style of doing things. I have my own style of doing things. And you know what? The attractiveness of your business is in bringing out your uniqueness. You will be an attractive person for people to work with when you are you and when you're not trying to copy anyone in any way. That's where the magic is. Okay. So coming back to the, let's come back to the PPT file over here. Okay. So last August when I launched my business, I'm just going to share some stats with you. Okay. Now before I share this with you, can I have all of your commitment that you will not share this with anyone. Okay. This is just between us. Okay. Because this is our inner circle community and I'm openly sharing my journey with you. Okay. So is that okay? Just type yes in the comment box. Okay. So please don't share any of this data with anyone, because I'm sharing this with you just to let you know on the potential and the scalability of this particular business model. Last August, I launched the Freedom Business Model course. I the first month I did 2.91 lakhs. Okay. 128 customers. And when I launched this, I was selling it at 999 rupees, 1000 rupees I start with. Okay. I'm selling now the same thing at 5999. Okay. And I'm planning to increase it also. Last August, it was 36.32 lakhs. So within a span of 1 year, I've been able to grow 10 times in a monthly income level. Okay. I'm sharing this with you, not to brag, not to impress you, nothing, but just to impress upon you on what is the potential and the scalability of this business model if you do this right. How many of you are excited when you see this? Yeah. I would like you to just type in the comment box committed, because the word is commitment. I've never missed a single webinar for the last 52 weeks. Okay. Few weeks. I've been doing 2 webinars a week consistently every single week. So these numbers, if I show you, it is only the consistency that has got me the results, nothing else. And analysis of my own business, looking at it, how I can improve, how I can tweak it, getting feedback from you. And there's been a lot of hard work along the way. Showing up every Thursday for all of you, answering questions, getting feedback, going through those questions, creating new curriculums, you know, to support and serve you, creating new systems, including those meetups. So all of these things have been evolution of the feedback that I'm getting from all of you. Okay. So, and if you see I just followed these 5 pillars and I just kept trying to master each of these pillars one by one. So your roadmap on this journey to become an evolved expert at the ecosystem level is to master all these 5 pillars. The pillar of traffic generation. Right now I've kind of mastered the Facebook traffic part. Now I'm going to jump into the YouTube ads, which is really good. Okay. I'm jumping into influencer ads. If you get your hands on Intent Traffic Mastery by Vic, he's going to open up into those 12 different traffic sources. So I'm actually now learning and starting to move my budgets, not just depending on one platform or Facebook. Okay. Because if Facebook, you know, the algorithm changes, suddenly their prices go up, cost per lead bumps up for whatever reason, you know what? I cannot depend on this one source. You've got to keep testing different sources and also build organic traffic sources. Right now, even my YouTube channel, I activated it. I'm pushing videos over there. I'm, you know, really stuffing it with the right keywords. Just now touched, I'm going to touch on 12,000 subscribers within a span of 3 months. I've been actively working on the YouTube, and I'm getting a lot of leads organically from YouTube as well. So I would like all of you to keep in mind that traffic always have a dual approach. Focus on mastering the paid game, but when you're mastering the paid game, also get on YouTube. And I'll tell you why YouTube. Because platforms like Facebook and Instagram, they're always changing. Okay, they're always changing. And even now you have TikTok and you have all these different things that are coming up. Okay. The whole concept of the regular social media platforms like Facebook and all of this is all about how it can be on the news feed. And the news feed is growing, is going so fast. Okay, so everything depends on the timing that you post. Unless you're putting money, you won't be on the top of the news feed. Having said that, if you look at YouTube on the other hand, is something which is more long-standing. It's more long-standing. Consider YouTube as a replacement of television. People are not watching TV as much these days as they're watching YouTube. So if you're able to build yourself on YouTube in such a way that you are the show, okay, infotainment, and able to give value to your audience and start building it, you know, you apply the right methodologies of ranking your content, you know what? That can be a long-term organic lead source for you. All of you with me on this? Just type with you in the comment box. So traffic generation, go with a twofold approach. Okay. List building, follow all the systems. Your email is the money is in the list. The money is in the relationship with your list. And right now I'm building three lists. I have my email list. I have my chatbot list, and I have my SMS list. Okay. And I'll deconstruct some of the new learnings, new findings, you know, as and when I have more data to share with all of you. I'll do that. Okay. Conversion pillar. I do all my conversions through webinars. How to sell through webinars, how to communicate through webinars. So once you're in my Freedom Setup Challenge, I'm going to teach you all of that. How to sell, how to construct the 90-minute pitch, a value-based pitch. So you give a lot of value and then you also pitch. And all of you came into my webinar, okay? And I always do live webinars. And I give that offer only in a live webinar because the way that I bring people into the community matters a lot, rather than just me directly selling it to my website. I've seen a few cases. People have directly gone to my website, they bought the courses, and you know, they think that this is, you know, getting rich fast or something like that. They don't come in the right context. So it's very important that all of you, even you're converting customers, you're bringing them into your world with the right mindset and the right context. Okay. Copywriting. In fact, that I'm working on that course. It'll be launching soon. How to write for social media, how to write on the emails that people actually open those emails. How do you write ads? How do you write blogs? There are so many different segments there because words is what's going to help you also create that pre-framing and the pre-fluencing them to actually make the decision. Okay. And then what I'm doing here is tribe building. Okay. And tribe building also is something which you will learn as you do it. Even if you have 5 people, 10 people, start nurturing a tribe. Even if you have 5, 10 customers, start meeting every week. Like what I'm doing right now, every week I'm there. You be there every single week for them. And once you step into a leadership role of serving them, you, even when you learn, you're always learning to teach. Whenever I'm listening to stuff from Vic, whenever I'm listening to stuff from other, you know, mentors I'm learning from, I'm always thinking about how I can share this with you. How I can take that knowledge and adapt it for you so that you can achieve the goals that you want. So your whole learning will be on a different level. Okay. How many of you have understood the depth of these 5 pillars today? Yeah. Just type got it in the comment box. Yes. So to really call yourself as a level 5 expert, as an ecosystem expert, you got to be a master of all these 5 things. And let's look through Vic's model here. The digital ecosystem blueprint is this. I think all of you would have anyway seen this in the first video of my Freedom Business Model course, but let me refresh it and go a little bit deeper and give you a new angle to the same blueprint that you see here. Okay. See, traffic is the first pillar that you need to master. And as you know, Vic has shared with me, in fact, he shared with all of us, that there are 3 types of traffic sources. Okay, I'll come to that in the next blueprint. The purpose of traffic is for you to capture that traffic. And for you to capture that traffic, you need to have your opt-in page, ClickFunnels, you need to have your email system, GetResponse, ConvertKit. You need to, you know, this is your internal traffic source. Then you need to get them into a pre-frame funnel. Like for me, my pre-framing is my webinar. And in the webinar, I sell my product, which is my freedom business model. And once somebody buys the product, then I automatically bring them into my ecosystem. And my ecosystem right now consists of my teachable system, which is my where all of you are accessing my courses. It consists of my social network, which is internetlifestylehub.com, where all of you are engaging and interacting with other members. And that becomes a support forum. So people who buy the product, in fact, all of you, you see there's more value than just the product. There's something more. There's the community element to it, which is the hub. Okay. And that is what's helping me get these kind of results. So all of these components, if these components are not there, then there is, you know, you're going to be just stuck at the level one or level two of a business. The ecosystem consists of all these four elements over here. Okay. And if you look at traffic here, let's go deeper. Let's zoom into the traffic blueprint, which Vic has given me. There are three levels of traffic. And this is what I would want each and every one of you to master in the 90 days phase. Okay. So now that you got started in this game, you've just, you know, started on the journey, you're understanding all these principles. In the first 10 days, you're going to be understanding all the concepts. Okay. The next 30 days, once you go through my freedom setup challenge, I'm going to help you set up all these systems on your own. I want you to do it on your own, get your feet wet, get your hands wet, and then go through the grind to understand how these connections are all made and how you can manage your own ecosystem. Once this is done, the only thing that you need to focus on after this is traffic. Okay, now in traffic itself, even right now, if you ask me, I'm still in level one. I've not even moved to level two or level three. There's much more to learn. And the reason I've surrendered to my mentor Vic is because this guy has done all of this. Okay, so level one traffic is influencer media, 24-hour traffic media, social media, display media, and PPC. Okay, all of this come under the first level traffic, which is the most basic knowledge to have. From here, once you know there's something working, then you can advance yourself into CPA traffic and traffic media X. There's something more to this where you can go. You can even spend like $500,000 a day on traffic if you want. Okay, there are some places where you can go, and Vic actually points us to those places. And you have domination traffic, where it's perpetual traffic machine, syndicate traffic, and ultimate traffic media, where you can start to, you know, dominate your market by getting thousands and millions of eyeballs to your offers. Okay, but for you to move to level two and level three, you need to first master level one. Okay. And then you have retargeting and you know, your opt-in page, data aggregation. That's a whole different game. Right now, it may seem a little overwhelming to you, but as you do it, you'll understand. See, when I started getting mentored under Vic, and when he was talking about data aggregation, I didn't have a clue about what he was talking about. I didn't have a clue. I just knew it theoretically. But now, with 6,000 people in my database, who are actually inside the hub, with you know, 50,000 leads, And now I understand what is data aggregation. I really need to segment people in the right way. I need to send the right communication to the right people. I need to start, you know, having the right kind of automation and the warm-up sequences for people at different stages of the journey. All this comes under data aggregation. So unless you have enough data, there won't be anything to aggregate. Okay. So don't worry about it even if you don't understand this right now. But conceptually, if you get it, just type in the comment box, "I get it," in the comment box. This is your journey. It means it's going to take you a year to assimilate all of this. And it's going to take another 2 or 3 years for you to master these two. And once you have mastery in traffic and conversions, it's like you not only have the well, but you've actually put in a motor in that well, like a high speed motor that can pull water out 24/7. Okay. That's what this we're talking about here. So, you guys want to see something even more crazy? Yeah, just type BIO in the comment box. Type BIO in the comment box. Yeah. Okay, good. Now, I've been learning from Vic. I got from him the ecosystem model. And then now I'm learning from a guy called Sam Owens, okay, consulting.com. This guy is crazy, okay? Vic is doing $1 million per month, and see how much this guy is making per month. Okay. Now, disclaimer, I'm not going to, even though I'm going to play his video, I don't want you to go and buy this guy's course or do anything. Okay. I'm just going to show you which is the next level, and please follow Mike's game plan. Okay. Because right now I'm at a stage where I need to really scale traffic, and that's why I'm going to a person like this guy. Okay. So until I recommend it to you, please don't jump the gun and think that you're too smart to go and do something else. Okay. All of you got it? Yeah. Just type with you in the comment box before I share this. Please follow my lead, because I know a lot of people who try to jump the gun and they're not at the maturity level to go to the next level to do stuff. Okay. So this guy does some insane amount of money. Okay. Check this out.
I'm going to show you how you can grow your business from 100 grand a year to 100 grand a month to 100 grand per day. Yes, that is $100,000 per day.
That's some bullshit.
I know what you're thinking. You're probably like, who the hell is this dude with a whiteboard and some pictures? And how the hell is he going to show me how to go to 100 grand a month or 100 grand a day? I bet you're just sitting there thinking,
that's some bullshit.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to crack this LaCroix here and I'm going to show you some proof. All right, so here I am logged into our backend system, and you can see that from Jan 1st, 19 to Jan 31st, 19, we made a total of $2.695 million in revenue. And of that, $1.996 million was cash collected, leaving $699,000 in accounts receivable. And this came from a total of 816 customers in a single month. Now, if you want to see proof of that cash collected, here I am logged into our Stripe account. And you can see that for the same time period, we did $1.93 million USD in cash collected net. And you can see that on many days, we were over $100,000 USD in cash collected. Now, if you're wondering how we generated that much volume and customers and sales, well, here I am logged into our Facebook Business Manager account. And here you can see our different ad accounts. And you can see we've spent quite a lot of money. I'll add it for up for you. 2.5 million, 5 million, 5.25 million, 5.3 million, 5.9 million, 7.9 million, roughly about $8 to $8.2 million spent on Facebook ads. Now, you'd hope that if someone was spending that much money on ads, they would, you'd hope they'd know what they're doing. And we do, because we consistently and reliably turn paid advertising dollars into profit day in, day out, consistently for years, and we never stop. Here I am logged into Google AdWords, and you can see that we've spent $3.97 million on AdWords and generated 1.46 million clicks, 364 million impressions, and we've converted 257,000 people. Well, you can see I'm logged into our HR software, and we have a total headcount of 18 employees. So this is a lean and mean organization, making 2 to 3 mil a month, profitable, and 18 employees. Proof tastes good.
All of you type in the comment box, freaking crazy. Because this guy is freaking crazy. $3 million a month, okay? 20 crores a month, 18 employees, and he's selling one product, is a $2,000 product, which is a front end, and he's got like a 5,000 and some 10,000, something like that, okay? Now, this guy spends $500,000 on Facebook ads per month, and he's cranking out $3 million per month through Facebook. I mean, of course, Facebook and Google all put together, but $3 million per month is what he makes currently, okay? Now, if you look at it, he is also following the same principle of what Vic just shared, same ecosystem-based model. Digital product, from digital product, he gets them to community. And of course, his target market is global. Like, not many people in India know about this guy. He's from New Zealand. He's now based in New York. And most of his customer base is Australia, Europe, and US. Okay, so it's only the English-speaking countries. Now, how do I know about this? Because I'm constantly analyzing and seeing what's happening in the world and who are the game changers, who are the guys who are the movers and shakers. And even when it comes to this guy, pretty much the same values like Vic. Okay, he's never written a book. He's never sold from stages. He's never done any of the typical stuff that people would, the typical coaches do. The guy is cranking $3 million per month, chills, sits. He's in New York and he's only 26 years old. Okay, so now he's 29 years old now, okay? Just got married recently. Are you mind blown? Just type mind blown in the comment box. 29-year-old guy, okay? Now, this is the potential of what you're going to be doing. But please go through these different stages that I shared with you, okay? Follow this blueprint. 10 days, understand concepts. 30 days, set up your systems. 90 days, start to achieve your first milestones, your first 3 lakh rupees per month, your first, you know, 1 lakh rupees per month. What was your goal? What was your financial frequency? You got to keep raising that financial frequency, by the way, okay? See, one thing I learned is if your income level is not as if your income level is not as what you expect, it only means that you have to grow to the level that the income matches in your life. Okay. If your income is low right now, it only means that you got to grow. You got to expand your awareness. And that's why those four rituals on a daily basis, it's so important. Stranger Secret in the World, Goal Card, reading the Creed, and also writing your goals. When you keep expanding and expanding and expanding your awareness, you know, that's when it'll manifest in your life. And that's why when I got into the 4-person challenge going through Vic, he just pushed the boundaries. You know, whenever I listen to him, even those videos are really long, something happens. Some ideas just come in. Okay. And that's where the transformation happens. Okay. So now I shared this with you. There are four phases of growth. First 10 days, focus, setup, sell, and scale. Okay. This is the typical flow of how you need to evolve as an expert in digital age and build your ecosystem. So on that note, can I share with you your 90-day game plan? Yes, type BIO in the comment box. Type BIO in the comment box. I'm going to give you your 90-day game plan and what you need to do in the first 10 days, the next few days, okay? Now, already you know the game plan based on what I've given you in the document, but in essence, in your first 10 days, you need to be clear on your niche. You need to be clear on your target market. You need to be clear about your own designation. What do you want to be known for? You need to be clear about your mission. Who do you want to serve? And what is the name of your community? And what would be the names of your products? Okay. And as I was going through, you know, Sam Owens and some of his views and training, because he also, has built something really phenomenal here. He says that, the whole concept of B2B and B2C is all total bullshit. It's total crap. Ask me why. Ask me why in the comment box. He says this is one of the biggest, stumbling blocks to progress in today's day and age because of tagging oneself as a B2B or a B2C person. Because you know what? It creates so much of distortion that people in the B2B, they think that they have to speak a different language. They have to wear some suits and they need to be talking professional, and the B2C people can be casual and they can do something in a different way. That's totally not true. His philosophy is that we are in the P2P business, person-to-person business. It is not about B2B. It's not about B2C. Because at the end of the day, it's one person connecting with the other person. How many of you are with me on this? Yeah. Because suppose I say that, okay, you are an accountant. So an accountant has to speak in a particular way. You have to dress in a particular way. You have to do things in a particular way. You know what? It creates so much of distortion. Whereas if you put yourself as a person to person, and if you're thinking about, okay, even though I'm an accountant, who am I really serving? Maybe you're an accountant and you are really there to serve the real estate business. So your whole messaging and it will change from you as a person to the real estate builders, as you know, that is the segment, but there'll be a person over there, the owner of a real estate company will be the person, and your entire language and everything will start to communicate on a more, you know, deeper level. So that's the first thing that he says, that when you're creating your own game plan, first point is think in terms of P2P. Second thing is don't worry too much about your niche. Don't worry too much about your niche. He gives a couple of ideas on how do you really find your niche. The first idea is make note of the 5 things that you feel you're really good at. Okay, make a list of that. Second thing is send an email to 15 of your best friends, asking them the question: what do you think I am good at? From what you see me, what you have seen me, what do you think I'm really good in? What do you think I'm not good in? Okay, ask them both these questions. Okay. And when you get the feedback from 15 people outside, when you note down this, you'll actually know there's some pattern out there. You'll be able to hit a bullseye there. Don't overthink this. Don't think that you got to jump into a particular niche because there's a lot of money to be made there. That's actually the wrong thing. Of course, I've also propagated this initially when I was building my niche strategy blueprint. To some extent, it's okay. Like health, wealth, relationships, top 29, money making niches, all of that is fine. But ultimately, it has to come from your core. It has to be something which you feel like doing for the rest of your life. And the narrower you go, the better it is. And that's why I've also said this, that the ideal target market for you is somebody who's just like you, who's going through the same problem. Okay. So just to give you an idea, see, when I did my clarity checklist for myself, this is what I did. So my niche is digital entrepreneurship. My target market are knowledge givers. My designation is I want to call myself a lifestyle entrepreneur on a mission to help 100,000 people live a lifestyle of freedom. And that's why I created the Internet Lifestyle Hub. And that's where the product name Freedom Business Model came out of it. So just use this simple checklist here to just come up with something fast, but don't overanalyze and on the niche. Pick something and run with it. That's it. Just go with it. And you know what? Once you get on the journey, it'll evolve. Based on how you're serving the community, it'll start to evolve. All of you with me on this? Just type MS in the comment box. Makes sense. If this makes sense, just type MS. Don't spend too much of time getting into analysis, paralysis, thinking about your niche. Do those two checklists that I gave you. Make a note of your top five things that you're good in. Top five, ask feedback from 15 other people. And you just make a decision. And then launch. Then make it right later on. Okay. Fantastic. So that's what the elevator pitch is. So when I introduce myself to anyone, for me, it's a very straightforward elevator pitch. I would say, hi, my name is Siddharth Rajshekar. I'm a lifestyle entrepreneur. I'm the founder of the Internet Lifestyle Hub, and I'm on a mission to help 100,000 people live the internet lifestyle. So your elevator pitch should be based on these six checklist points that are there. And the more clearer you get on this faster, the more money that you can make. Okay. In other words, if I can wake you up at 2:30 in the morning, if I pour a bucket of water on you and if I ask you, what is your mission? You should be able to tell this in 15 seconds. It's like the 2 a.m. check. What do you say? The 2 a.m. checkpoint. That is your elevator pitch. So how many of you are going to work on your elevator pitch? How many of you are going to work on it? Just type me in the comment box. Excellent. Vipul, you're already on track. Yes. Fantastic. So what you got to do in essence is take those ideas and then you start to do things for others. In case sometimes, you know what, if you're just starting off, if you're not sure about it, start to do some work for free for other people. Just do free work, okay, for your friends. And then once you get some pulse with them, then maybe you can move into the next level, do it with them. Then you coach some people, then get into group coaching, and then you know, you can actually build your whole bunch of bonuses. Now this may take some time, but you know what? Even if you're going to be creating a product, create your basic tripwire product, but then you offer something which you can do for them or some kind of a coaching where you can get live feedback from your audience. That is the principle. Okay. Good. So now let's come back over here. And I want to share with you another concept here, which is the next 30 days. So then 10 days, once this is clear, then you go through my Freedom Setup Challenge. In my Freedom Setup Challenge, I want to help you design your curriculum. Okay. Create your curriculum for your tripwire core product. Then get a good photo shoot done. Not many people talk about this, okay? In my Freedom Startup Challenge, I go deep into this. See, the photo shoot and your name logo need to represent something. So, okay, so like for example, I have my name logo and I got this photo shoot done in Miami, Florida. And it has to represent what you stand for. Because I stand for freedom, I talk about internet lifestyle. I needed to take a photo shoot which is outdoor, which is not so formal, a little bit more casual style, you know, and even if it's going to be something formal, it has to be like semi, you know, I cannot be like an uptight person with tie. I never wear ties. I hate ties. Okay. That is not me. So when you do a photo shoot, make sure it represents your style. It brings out the flavor that you're looking for. Standardize on your colors. Like I chose orange as my color. And as far as my courses are concerned, I use like this, that purplish color. And I've actually set the palette, color palette for whatever I'm doing. Now, even on my YouTube channel, I've set up some of those things. Okay, so you look at this, my e-cover design, everything has to represent. See, orange is my base color, and I'm using that orange color in the border over here. Even though the colors may change from product to product, I'm still using that same consistency, that's what's there. So all of these subtle things make a big difference, and this is what you need to do. When you go through my Freedom Setup Challenge, I'm going to give you those ideas and why you can get this done, why you can get the logo done, why you can get your photo shoot done. All of that stuff is already covered, okay, in my level 2 course. So once you do this, then you set up your domain, Then you set up your hosting, your email marketing system, your ClickFunnels system, your webinar system, your membership hub, your website system, your chatbot system, your tracking system, your payment gateway system, your check, and then you check all the integrations, and then you're ready to start selling into the webinars. How many of you right now, let me just do a quick poll to find out right now. How many of you, just answer this poll. Which level are you in right now? Level one or level two? Level one is not 7 courses, actually 9 courses that you bought. Okay, I need to make an edit on that. 10 courses, if I also include the affiliate income blueprint. See, all of you who are in level one, you anyway understand all these concepts. But in level two, I actually make you do all of this stuff. And I want you to do it yourself. My Freedom Setup Challenge, it's all about this. Okay. And it's all in this sequence. In 30 days, you got to keep implementing. Actually, you can finish it in 18 days if you really go full on. There are some people I know who finished everything in 1 week, but you can do it fast. I mean, you can do it at your own pace also. Okay. But 30 days is ideal for you to finish setting up. Once you set up all of this, your next logical step, okay. If you see what I'm actually doing here through the Freedom Setup Challenge, I'm teaching you how to fish. Because once you set it up on your own, you can fish for the rest of your life. You know that quote, right? If you give a man a fish, you feed him for a day. You teach a man to fish, you can feed him for a lifetime. And that's why I want you to go through this grind, okay, this entire setup phase over here. Okay, this middle segment over here. And then 90 days, you got to sell, okay? The next 90 days is the webinar selling formula, the Facebook traffic formula. And then you start mastering this game now, okay? After 90 days to a year, you start mastering fast traffic, strategy, scale, and domination traffic. For how many of you now, the roadmap is much more clearer than what it was when you came into today's session? Just type super clear in the comment box. Type super clear. Excellent, excellent. Nice. Fantastic. Good. Now let's jump back into the stages of mastery. Okay? The stages of mastery. There are 7 stages. In fact, I'm just going to construct, layer by layer. So what do you want? We want the good life, right? You want the good life. You want to live a happy life, good life. And each one of us may have our own definitions of what is a good life. So you need to define that. But that's more free time, more family time, more time to travel, more time to pursue your hobbies, your passions, whatever may be the case. Define that lifestyle that you want, which is the good life that you want. Now, in order to achieve the good life, what do you need? Type in the comment box. Let's see if you can guess layer by layer. What do you need? Yes, money. Money, 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 money. Okay. So we need a lot of money. Okay. Yes. Some people may say, you know what, money is not important in life. But you know what, one of my mentors says that money can solve a lot of problems that not having money brings about. How many of you agree with me on this? Money solves a lot of problems that not having money brings about. So yeah, it's very important. Money is important. Okay. So in order to have more money, what do you need? Let's see if you can guess number 3 now. Let's have a thing here. Somebody saying skills, somebody says purpose, somebody needs a plan, somebody says plan. Okay. Some of the answers are right. Okay, somebody saying, so we need you, Sid. No. Okay, I'm going to be there to guide you, but you need sales. You need sales and the ability to sell. Okay, so in order to achieve sales, what do you need? What do you need to be good at? To generate consistent sales, what do you need to be good at? You need to be good at conversions. Okay, so when it comes to conversions, I'm talking about webinars. How do you conduct the webinars? How you're able to attract people, you know, using your mission. How do you really get people, how you can get people to buy into your vision? People are not buying your product. They're buying your vision. You didn't buy my product. You bought the vision of freedom. True or no? The product is the means to the goal. But what I sold is not the product. I sold the vision. Okay? So you need to be good at selling the vision, and that's what's going to create the conversion. Okay? Now, in order to get conversions, what do you need? Let's see. Yes. You need a list. In other words, leads, okay? Leads, lists, all of that would come under this. You need to keep building a list. I'm constantly building a list because I need that list to keep growing, to feed my webinars, to feed the sales, to feed the money, and to feed the good life, okay? So in order to have list, what do you need? Exactly, all of you are bang on. We need a capture system, a capture mechanism to capture the list. And to capture leads, we need to have traffic. Okay. So traffic is a very core skill that each and every one of you need to master. And you need to be hands-on. Of course, all of this, you know, traffic, capture list, conversion, you need to master all of these pillars, those five pillars. But this is the sequence to the good life. So if you focus on mastering each of these pillars, there's no doubt that you're going to be making money and having a good life. Does this make sense? I have to attribute this to Vic. Okay, Vic, I'm just sharing what Vic shared in his episode number 26 that he just launched like 2 days back. You know, I'm going through his 4-person challenge also right now. Okay, so just type yes. Okay, now Vic says that there are 5 most important words in business. And if you get these 5 words in business, you will have a well that can feed generations to come. How many of you would like to know what are these 5 words? Okay, let's see if you can make any guesses. What are the most 5 words? Somebody saying trust. Some people are saying return on investment, consistency, product value, sales, customer. It's not one word. Sorry, it is 5 different words. I'm not saying 5 letters. Okay, I'll bring it up. Okay, don't worry about it. So this, if you get it, life is not going to be the same. How can I help you? That's the question I keep asking you. How can I help you? How can I help you? How can I help you? The more feedback I get from you, I'm going to be helping you achieve that result. All of you note this down. So as you're building your tribe, as you're building your digital ecosystem, always keep thinking about this question. How can I help my audience? How can I help my audience? So whatever I'm learning, I'm always thinking about how I can help you. Okay. So when you are in this channel of thought, in this energy, right, then it becomes into a whole different game. Do you know whenever I ask questions, okay, let me just show this to you. Okay. It's something which you guys will really find this valuable. Every week or every other week, I answer detailed questions, right? How many of you already know that? Yes. So what I do is, I'm going to show you 2 separate files, and I'll show you how I've integrated all of this. Okay. So I have 2 spreadsheets right now. One spreadsheet has all the questions. The first, you know, every week when I ask questions, I give you a link to a Google form, right? And all of you ask me these questions. I have like over 700 questions. Okay. Some of the questions are still not answered. You know, like what is the approximate cost of Facebook ads? Bank is not opening current account for me. What do I do? Then I have something like, what is the additional cost incurred to get the additional funnel preparation done? And like this, if I go, I have over 600 plus questions that you have asked me. How can I use your weekly IC meetings? Okay, this is my initial set of questions. How to set up a chatbot in Messenger? You know, I did a video on this later on. This is in 2018, I got questions. Now, do you think these questions are valuable for my business? Yes or no? I am getting direct feedback from all of you. So when you're running your group, right? When you're running your inner circle tribe, make sure that you answer questions and you set up a Google form and you keep getting this data. When you're getting these data, you can look through this. And what I've done is I've made a list, looked at all of this, and I've made my 100K plan here for what YouTube videos I need to record. I have over 83 videos that I need to record on all these different questions. Okay. Where do you find a powerful Facebook post? How to get comfortable doing videos? What's the best hosting plan to take on Bluehost? Best Indian payment processor for buying digital products? All this stuff. I've got like a whole bunch of questions. And these are the questions that I am going to be recording, you know, videos on. And all my content, my Facebook Live, everything is going to be based around what you ask me. And this fundamental principle goes back to what Vic is saying is this: how can I help you? So my courses are all related to what you ask me. And so the same mindset when you adopt, you will be able to build an ecosystem that will be truly valuable to your customers. And you'll have customers for life. And it will always keep evolving. There is no ending point to this. Okay. Some of the content that gets redundant, knock it off your hub and feed it with new content. And when you're always keeping it fresh and when you're always keeping it relevant to your audience, that's when you have a thriving digital tribe, a community. How many of you, today's session made a lot of sense? Yes, just type game on in the comment box if you're ready for this game. And I'm talking about, there's no limit to this game. We have guys like Sam Owens doing $3 million per month. They're looking at 21 crores per month. That is the potential business. Vic is doing 7-8 crores per month in Indian rupee terms. Okay, and you've seen my success journey in the last 1 year, 10x, like 36 lakhs per month right now. Okay, just through these. I'm not talking about affiliate income stream. That's another income stream altogether. This is only purely based on my products. Okay, so the secret to all of this, I think all of you already know it. Please look at your goal cards every day. When I look at my goal card, $1 million per month, $1 million per month, I don't even know how I'm going to reach there. But, you know, all of these situations in life, new learnings, new nudges, new insights from different people, it's all pointing me in that direction. Okay. So please look at your goals every day. Please read the creed every single day. Listen to the strangest secret in the world twice in a day. Okay. How many of you here are actually struggling with money? Just be honest. Just type me in the comment box. Okay, I feel you, I know it, I've been there, I know the situation, okay? If you've typed me in the comment box, I want you to listen to the strangest secret in the world twice a day. Twice a day. When I started on this journey for the first 60 days, I did it twice a day without a single break. The reason why your money situation is bad is because of, it's your operating system, okay? And while you're listening to it, It's all about stepping into your courage and making those decisions. Maybe going and shooting that video. Maybe going completing that course that you've been procrastinating for a long time. Maybe doing that first webinar and selling those courses. And maybe nobody has bought your courses, but still going and pushing and doing it without quitting. That's what the nourishment you need right now. Okay. The strangest secret in the world is a 1956 audio by Earl Nightingale that created more millionaires than any other personal development in the 1960s. So don't underestimate the power of that program. It's really, really powerful. Even today, I listen to it every single day once. Okay? So please do that. Number four is write your goals every day. How many of you are going to start this from today? Just type me in the comment box. Excellent. Start this from today. And number five is stay connected with the community, attend the meetups. And I would say meetups are anyway happening, but be there every Thursday. You're here this Thursday. Do not miss Thursday masterminds, because if you miss this, then your energy will start to go down. It's like you need to recharge your phone every day, right? You want to recharge yourself every week. So be here. How many of you are going to commit yourself to being here every Thursday, no matter what? Type me in the comment box, yeah. Because it requires this kind of commitment. And for me also, I want to say that I'm committed to you. I want to show up. I'm going to show up every single week.
There are people pushing me and constantly staying accountable and creating that safe space for me to grow.
Before joining ILH, little did I realize I have a lot of potential and how to get it to women.
I was not having clarity on my mission statement.
I had certain problems of how to structure my knowledge.
I was handicapped of marketing, digital marketing, social media.
After joining this community, I realized the potential of reaching out to women.
Now I can do at least three things. One, structure my knowledge. Two, how to use and set up all the online tools necessary. And three, take my knowledge to the greater audience.
Now I know what to do, how to do. And now I'm very confident about all these things.
Most important thing what I came to know was this is a givers community.
I'm living my dream life through the internet lifestyle hub.